Oh! French. And it's about this, I guess the first two songs here are about unrequited love. And the hummingbird goes around and you can hear the hummingbird flying everywhere. And it finally lands on this beautiful flower, and to drink the nectar of the flower, and then the flower dies, and the hummingbird never does not know if the flower loved it in return.
I'm
sorry, this is as good as it's gonna get, and I just felt like, oh my gosh, this is awful if I have to live like this for the rest of my life. And when I first came back to church, was able, like, I had the energy to be awake and whatnot, this was a song that I sang. And so, you know, a lot of times when you go through those harrowing life experiences, you think, not only why me, but it's really difficult. And so this song And when I asked Nathan to sing a song with me, I had no idea what the lyrics meant. I'm not an opera buffa, like I don't know these things. So he was a good sport, said yes. So
happy to drink with you.
It's technically the drinking song. So.
Le pion, le pion.
frustrated me because I like loved everything. I loved tennis. I loved basketball. That didn't last long because I'm 5'11". I love, you know, everything. I loved music theater. I loved viola, everything. And she'd say, Bethany, this was in the 8th grade, I remember her. And she's since passed away, so I can say this. She said, Bethany, you're going to be the jack of all trades and the master of none. And I want to be like, you know what, Mrs. So-and-so? Become the master of you. So here is, without further ado, Swan for viola.
Thank you.
said, but you know, for your recital, you can't just do all music theater stuff. I was like, I know. You have to do something in all the languages. I know. But now it's the desserts. Now we get to have that. So, without further ado.
Thank you. other person was. And so she said, okay, I'll bring a rose, and then, you know, when, and I'll show up at such and such time, and then you can come and we can meet. Well, she shows up at the rendezvous such and such time with the rose, and then her enemy, or George, comes and saw that it was Amalia, and he's like, I can't go in because, you know, this is not, no, like, no, she can't know that it was me. So later on, she was feeling sick, so George comes and brings her ice cream, and she, and Amalia kind of tells George what had happened. And she's not used to seeing George as being a nice person because they're kind of bitter enemies. And he said, oh yeah,